Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds, Peril on Gorgon. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're heading to these mines to get the last clue. It's a series of four comic books, believe it or not, about a... What's he called? I'll try to remember it on my own, but... Crap. Not coming. Archibald Excelsior. Virgil Sharp left his clue in the Gorgon Mines. So we're going to the Gorgon Mines. And basically on the spine of each book is a phrase. So we need the last word of the phrase. There's actually the third word. Right, the last one is enter. So, yeah. End of the first paragraph. Comic spine is the word speak, something, and enter. So you have to find out the last word, or the third word, and then we can use that to get into the secret hideout. See who or what might be in there. I'm thinking it'll be a treasure trove of goodies. So let's go check it out. There's really nothing that nearby we can fast travel to. You have to go from the OCI lower exterior. And you know what? Last time we went there, there were marauders there.
So okay, keep him quiet.
Let's go keep quiet. And, check it out. They haven't come back yet. Good. Alright, terminal clue is this way. Oh, we've got frost sword soldiers, okay. Like child's play, huh? Sure, these guys have come back over here, but there's no need to mess with them. At least I don't think that's... No. Because we're going here. And I don't know if it's just a hole, or if we're going inside a structure, you know, inside something.
I've seen more than enough marauders to last a lifetime.
I got your back, Captain. Ain't a single mantisaur gonna sneak up on us.
Okay. Give me alarm, make me think someone's coming. Mantisaurus. All the way over here at Blue? So that must be the mines. Oh. Oh, it was a separate one. These two had a fight. It's pretty much the only outside area I think we have not been to. Oh. The only thing is, that's not the way. Not the... No. Okay, so maybe we haven't been here either. I'm not sure. Doesn't look like somewhere we can go inside. I mean, I'm gonna check it out. I don't think we've been here either, but this is not the mines, obviously. These. Nope. Yes, there's nothing we can get into. Alright. It's not where we want to be going. We need to go to the mines. Itch. Stand by, guys. This way. Right? Yes. Giant cog. So after we explore the mines and then explore the secret hideout, we'll be heading back to the main quest, synthesis and manufacturing center. Total clue, getting closer. Now some people think that the marauders came from the mines, but we know
better.
Anyone
else feel like the walls are almost leaning in?
Pretty much.
Did the temperature just drop, or is it my imagination?
Both. Here's a frost sore soldier. Dead frost sore. Don't mess with us. Even if we mess with you first, don't mess with us. Zero here. Can we use this? Looks like guns. We can go up that way. Or that way. Thank you. Well, the terminal clue's this way. Let's go up this way first. Quite a few. Maim or stagger.
Nice work.
You guys are just too good, damn. We are pretty kick ass. I keep souping up tinkering and souping up everyone's weapons. Go over here first. There's another area over there. Doesn't seem to be that there's an inside area. It's just like this stuff out here. Just fine with me. Virgil's research site. Really eerie area, huh? Terminal clue.
This has got to be one of those research sites we're looking for.
Mm-hmm.
It's sort of lonesome, isn't it?
Absolutely. First, we'll check out Maurice Walton's datapad, Virgil. Making progress on the grav plating for the package, though not nearly as fast as you'd like. Given the spin rate of Gorgon, the anomaly I've been observing is only present in the sky 3 hours out of every 24. Doesn't help that I have to readjust my telescope every couple minutes to keep tabs on the slippery bastard. Come by my workstation outside the manufactory dome when you've got a minute. The data this thing is throwing off is strange as all get out. Be ashamed to compromise the package with a misplaced zero, right? By the way, I check on Eustace. The fumes aren't doing him any favors. We ought to get him out of there as soon as we can. How's your sister coming with the schedule? By the marvelous mustache of Excelsior, Maurice. P.S. You gotta tell Birdie to stop bringing me food. If I have to eat another damn can of salt tuna fillets, I'm gonna hurl. Okay, here's a clue. A comic from the classic Ace Exterminator series, tragically cancelled after its brief 4-issue run, scribbled in felt tip on the comic spine is the word friend. Friend, enter? Well, this is number 2. Friend and enter. Yeah, number 2 of 4. Check the other ones in a second. After his run-in with the Dancing Queen, proven hero Archibald Excelsior is mending his broken heart in the glitzy city of Fairview when a horde of vicious crystal canids escapes from the laboratory of an evil unemployed scientist. As the canids turn the city to ash with their plasma beam eyes, Excelsior descends into the depths of the lab to put down the leader of the pack, King Alpha. The king connives to sabotage Excelsior's trusty PET, and our hero is forced to fight with the only weapon in reach, the skull of King Alpha's own mother, Empress Crystalline Alpha. Crystalline Alpha? Will our mustachioed hero escape the king's jaws and heal his wounded heart? I don't know. So we found them all. They make the phrase, speak, friend, and enter. So either we're supposed to say, speak, friend, and enter, or we're supposed to say, friend, and then enter. So I wonder if we're going to find treasure in there, or is there going to be somebody in there? Well, this isn't a place we can enter. There's like a wall or something.
I'll keep quiet.
Best you do so. Should go in here. Looks like it might just be a closed off area, or maybe not. More frost sores. Mega? What? Mega ice cream, oh brother. I keep getting an itch in the same spot in my back. If I just remove the skin entirely, it won't itch anymore, right? Alright. Yeah, the Mega Ice Queen sounds like trouble. Let's maim her. Damage weakness. That's okay. I never like picking those. I have to repair this thing again already.
I hear something big scuttling over yonder.
Something else? Or is she just reacting as if the queen's not there? Oh, what a surprise. More Edwina time. Never thought we'd find that here. Glacial Manti Carapace. Somehow this shell. Yeah, I've read that before. Well, she's got like ammo and stuff, and her own Adrena time. Light machine gun Mark III. Coolant distributor. We need to go find a vending machine soon. That guy, what's his name? He gave me something. Forget his name. The guy we returned all these stuff to. All those audio logs, too. I forgot. He gave us something. A coolant distributor. Some engineers have suggested that modifying a weapon for use as an engine maintenance tool is a bad idea. Some engineers lack imagination. Special effect chilled. What did he give me? Wall of Swords, right. After... No. Are you wondering how hitting multiple enemies makes you harder to hit? What a stupid question. So it's an N-ray sword. That's pretty cool. That's what he gave us in return for us returning all those audio logs to him. Okay, so yeah, this is a closed off area. Mining accident. Oh, is that what it is? We came from this way. So we can go this way, okay. So it's not completely a dead end. Another log? Automated ATB injectors. Gimme.
I figured the mines were gonna be trouble.
Oh, lucky.
Didn't think they'd be crawling with mance. Must have gotten out of HIA a while ago, because they've been busy here. Something about the tunnels here gets under your skin and into the worst parts of your head. Makes you feel not yourself.
Alright.
In case I don't make it out of here. Marauders.
Oops.
Must have followed me from OCI. Time to make tracks while the mats are busy. I'm shedding some extra weight. It's yours if you find it, whoever you are. You need it more than I do now.
Okay. So I guess he's responsible for the dead marauders and frost sores. Not completely sure if this is near where we came up, so just in case. Yeah. And I guess we can't get in here. Just checking. What is that? Oh. Can't interact with this stuff, okay? We weren't down this way, right? Nope. We got live stuff over there. Runs over here, I'll shoot that. I was so ready too.
Wow, not even a scratch.
Wow. Still wondering who our mystery figure is. Keeps trying to thwart our attempts. They're supposedly gonna send people or things after us. It looks frosty over there, so we might have stuff. Oh, I hear another thing. From Lucky, maybe? Hmm. Poor Lucky, huh? it's a miner.
Benji. You remember that time? That time we... Yeah, fishing. Down on Stellar Bay. You read my mind, Benj. Black sun on the water. Waves glinting like teeth. Swallow us whole. That sky.
That guy's dying.
The rock. It's whispering, Benj.
He's hallucinating.
Yeah, you hear it too. Wants me to crawl. Crawl down deep. Let the beast consume. Benji.
Really?
Can't hear you. You breathing? Ben? Ben?
So I recognize this area. Although I missed that because I was hiding behind that. I guess we're done. Some stuff is designed to see only when you're traveling a certain way. Let's see how they do that. Okay, so that's it for the mines. Short and sweet. Abandoned mines, okay. So the active quest is here. So let's go back to OCI Lure Exterior. We might have to come from above, though. Mm. I think we do, yeah. So we have to come from upper exterior and move across. They just wrapped it on. Or not even, they're canids, I think. You can have fast travel on your house dolls. Alright, well, I don't need the fast travel. I'm just gonna move around. Is this the right way? Pretty much. Secret Hideout Terminal. Yes. Speak, friend, and enter. Because that is sealed. Just in case. Enter True Fan Passphrase. Is that the passphrase? Really? Alright. Passphrase accepted. Speak, friend, and enter. One final task awaits thee, fair traveler. Oh, damn it. You must complete a test to prove your bona fides, but worry not. It should be simple for a true fan of Archibald Excelsior. Alright, wait.
Understood. I'll keep my head down.
Wait, then. Do we have to memorize this stuff? Should I be writing stuff down? Issue 1. Let me get something to write on here. Issue 1. Dispatch to... Olympus. Let's write down the important stuff. Olympus to get down a plague of ravenous mantimen. Intent on taking the seas for their own. Manti mastermind Pitts is second in command. Spindle Knight. Do we have them? Spindle Knights. I mean, I'm guessing this is going to be like multiple choice, but Sisak, Sassafras, Fame Fatale. Oh no, that's Dancing Queen. Right? Okay, so then two. That's one. Whatever's in here better be worth it, that's all I gotta say. Two. As we're running with the Dancing Queen, Mending Broken Heart. Let's see, City of Fairview. Crystal Canids. Evil unemployed scientist. As the Canids begin to walk with Puzzle Bean. King Alpha. Empress Crystal and Alpha. He uses the skull as a weapon of Crystal and Alpha. Okay. Just writing down the names and locations, basically. Three. After pacifying the Canid threat, he goes to Hephaestus. Sprat Pack. It's an a cappella band called Sprat Pack. A new foe arrives. Buff Hardman. Super Dark Reclamation. Sprint Hardman. He uses a mind control ray. Okay. And then finally, Broken PET. Tartarus. Returns to haunt him. Let's see, so we got Colossus, Lava, and Hardman. Lightning struck the PET. Alright, the rest of the stuff I hopefully would remember. Okay, in issue number one, The Plague of the Manti Man, what was the name of the Manti Mastermind second in command, whom Archibald defeated in hand-to-claw combat? A Spindle Knight, Sisak, Sassafras. That's the love interest. That's not even... Kamen George isn't even recognized. Correct. Question 2 of 4. In issue 2, Attack of the Crystal Canids, what improvised weapon did our illustrious leader Archibald Excelsior use to exterminate King Alpha? Was the head of Empress Crystalline Alpha. Frankie got the living gun. The skull of King Alpha's own mother. These other ones are interesting. A hairpin belonging to his adoptive daughter, Virginia Yang girl. Virginia Yang girl detective. No, that's correct. In issue number 3, Invasion of the Flesh-Eating Sprats, Agent Buff Hardman foiled Archibald's heroic plan to liberate the underground metropolis of Hephaestus from the Sprat Pack by doing what? The mind control ray. Metallicus gel. Tricking Archibald with his dastardly mind control ray. Correct. In issue 4, the Colossus beneath Tartarus, how did Archibald ignite his signature weapon, the Pet, and put the titular giant down for good? With a bolt of lightning from above. With his last spacer's Corona cigarette. Alert! The passage is unbarred. Enter as a brother, or sister, Birdie, for you are now a certified, genuine, super science sidekick. Congratulations. Awesome.
This must have been where those researchers had their hideout. You think we can get inside?
Seriously, Parvati? Right after I open the door, you say that. You guys staying outside? Alright. Drawing Edith, Bijou Review. It better be something better than what I've been finding. The Pet! Ooh, that must be it, what we're looking for, I guess. 2,250 bits. Nice. Awesome. These people are probably all dead. Poor people. Yay! Check out this thing. Manufacturer unknown. Science weapon. This lovingly handcrafted replica energy axe bears a striking resemblance to the pest extermination tool wielded by Pope legend Archibald Excelsior. With his famed pet in hand, the inimitable Excelsior exterminated a plague of Mantymen, a horde of crystal canids, a pack of supervillainous singing sprats, and a molten giant the size of a mountain, all while nursing a broken heart. Only a true fan could have crafted such an improbable weapon. So, I don't want to use this. Should I bother giving it to... Can they even use that? 254... ...167... ...240... I don't know if they'll even use it, but... I'm not into the melee stuff. Awesome. It keeps defaulting to this. Last quest is that. So what I'm going to do... I should return really quick. Here we go. Awesome. That's what he looks like. That's pretty sweet. I guess you only got that loading screen when you, I was trying to land on the roof. You only get the loading screen show up when you successfully complete that.
Hey again, Strange. What can I get you? All sorts.
Yeah. Alright, so let's... I'm gonna get rid of that. Wall of Swords. Can't keep it all, you know? Thank you. I'm gonna be able to, tinker someone else's helmet or weapon. Oh, that's not what I'm trying to do. Thank you very much. Alright, repairing once again. Insufficient bits, insufficient impact hammer. He hardly ever uses it, or he never uses it. Eh, I'm not gonna bother tinkering that. So, that's at its limit. Can't do limit, limit, limit. We can do this. This is, what's his name? I get so bad at remembering names. Vicar Max. His helmet. And it's at its limit now. Okay, good. Sweet. Okay, so next episode, back to the main quest. SMC, Synthesis and Manufacturing Center, I think it stands for. We'll be heading back to that to finally get Olivia Ambrose's journal. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.